Hello Libras, how's it going? I am recording this video and getting it uploaded to you in the month of December so that we can look at January 2023's tarot reading for the horoscope sign of Libra. Whoops, that was a little bit of a fail. a shabby shuffle. With that being said, we are going to be looking at the events that are going to be happening in the month of January 2023. We're going to break it down week by week. So if you are new here, that is what I am doing. I'm not simply trying to look into just any energy. I'm specifically looking to see what events are going to be happening. What are those important thoughts that are going to be on your mind each week of the month? When we look at the month that way, I always feel like it kind of shows me what cycles people are going through. And so, let's get into it. Let's shuffle them out and start the reading. I'm going to lay down a top row here. And this top row is the events. I'm going to put down four different events. And then I'm going to put down a second row. That's going to be the reasoning section for why these events have happened. Each of these rows, one row, and then there will be two, three, and four, they're going to be dedicated to the different weeks of the month of January. The first row that we have right here is going to be the first of the month of January up until the 7th or 8th of the month. And this is the event for that week. Then the second row here is going to be the 7th or 8th of the month of January up until the 15th or so. And so we will get to see what event you are dealing with for that particular week. And then we have the reasoning card below it to show us what is the reason for this event happening. So now that I have it laid all out, let's get into it, Libra. Starting off with the first week of the month. And as you know, I am a single mother of three very young children. So they are playing and running around in the background, and I hope it doesn't bother you. I'm going to try and talk as loud as I can over top of them. So Libras, your first card is the Four of Cups. The Four of Cups here shows a person who's kind of bummed about something. Like a lump on a log, he is sitting here and he is looking down at the things in their life that aren't successful. And Libras, you do not need to be in that energy. What I want to see from you is gratitude. And I know that can be easier said than done. But the reason I say that is because in the typical Rider-Waite deck, while this person is frustrated, the hand of God is usually drawn on the card, trying to give him another cup, but he's not looking at it. He's so frustrated that he keeps looking at these cups when God is actually trying to offer another cup to him. And just to give you an idea of that card, if you look at it here, look at, there's the hand of God. But she's not paying attention to that. And this offering is way more important than the things that were lost. And so this energy shows us that whatever has happened to you, Libras, it was supposed to happen to you. And it was to get you to something that you can be even more satisfied with once you get to that level of appreciation and gratitude. Overall, though, it does seem, at least in this first quarter of the month, that something might be frustrating you. It could be with relationships or friends. It can feel like a loss, specifically. It's not like you just, you know, bumped your toe on something here. But it feels like something has, like, spilled. And you're very focused on it. You know, even, like, the loss of money, even. Or a household goal that you might have had. It's actually happened to you in the reasoning section here because this loss or this frustrating period of time is connected to the fact that you are going to go through a cycle of learning how to let go of certain things that you have been attempting to control, which is, you know, something humans naturally do. We've got the Four of Pentacles. And actually, I like the depiction of the Four of Pentacles even more so if I can find it here on the Rider-Waite deck again. It really, you know, hones in on that idea of somebody who absolutely wants something to go their way. Look at this. This guy is holding on to his valuables and he will not let go. He put them under his feet to protect them. He put them on his head. He wants what he wants and he won't let go of it. But sometimes it's important for us as humans to let go of the things that we think might be valuable but might not actually be serving us. Like ideals or beliefs, sometimes even relationships or people that we might have this need to let go of. Or even on a kind of internal level, we might need to let go of habits that we have. Overeating, using too much, you know, internet, phone, Facebook, addictions to things on the internet, you know, like filthy materials or things like that. Whatever it is that we need to let go of so that we can bring more gratitude into our life is the name of the game for the first week. Now, the second quarter of the month, again, this is going to be the 7th or 8th of the month onwards to the 15th or 16th of the month. My 3-year-old is very chatty right now, by the way. So again, I'm trying to talk over him, but he's having a full-blown conversation in the background. The second quarter of the month is the Wheel of Fortune, but it is in the reversal position. And if you look, it's the Magician. So it is a person who wants to manifest something. You want to bring something into your life, so to speak, and when it's in the reversal, there's that much more difficulty to trying to manifest something into your life. And so it can very well be that you are frustrated that something has not come into your life as quickly as you want it to be. And one of the important reasons that I say that could be is because the Knight of Pentacles is here. And if you look at the Knight of Pentacles, he has a big award, a big golden coin on his behind here, and a big wreath of victory. But he's the only horse of the deck that is standing still. And so it happens to be a card that means slow moving progress to get to your goal. Or to get to your goal. And honestly, Libras, for those of us who have an issue perhaps with, balancing our scales out, to be honest, then we have this brutal ability to be really impatient. And I say that because I also am a Libra. So I feel you on that one. Now the manifestation of something not coming in as quickly as you want, it doesn't have to be a bad thing here. Essentially, when we've got the Knight of Pentacles, there's a reminder that the slow moving progress things tend to be worth it way more in the end. And so the kind of concept is, again, for a second quarter of the month here, it's about gratitude. You know, being okay with things that might have been lost, being okay with things that might have been slow moving. But there is a concept that actually a double meaning here. I just realized. Oh goodness. My children playing, and I think my one son did a. Sorry, I just stuttered big time. A bit of a dive bomb. I stuttered because to say the word did and dive right next to it was a little bit difficult. And you may not know it because I'm such a talker, but I actually do have a slight stutter, especially on the words, the letters D and words like that. That particular word I stutter on. So that's all, folks. Now let's get on to it. The connection between these two is also that sometimes there's something that's good that's happening in your life, but when it's in the reversal, there's almost a, it's like this feeling that you don't recognize something that's actually good for you, which is what we see right here. And I used the Rider-Waite card to kind of show you guys that there could be more to be grateful for. And you know what? I really like that because I have, even myself, I've been sitting in that energy lately. You know, I've got goals with money, my business, I've got goals with my weight, and I wish I could be skinnier quicker.
You know what Buddy just said when I did him in the pink bedroom and put him on the couch? He said, "Thank, Hunter."
Oh, that's so nice, honey.
He literally did.
He did, I believe you. Keep playing. So, it's just a reminder that if we want things to go faster, if we're trying to rush ourselves into love, or if we're trying to make our money go quicker, it's okay. Actually, this card can mean, hey, just know this too shall pass. And I think that's kind of funny because immediately next to it is the Hermit. And what does the Hermit look like? Totally looks like Gandalf from Lord of the Rings, who takes his staff and says, "This too shall pass." And right underneath him, in the reasoning section, it's a literal double image of the hermit Diogenes with his staff saying, "This too shall pass. We've got to, you know, keep trucking on, keep trying to fulfill those wishes." But look at the eight, though, here. The eight of wands. You see how there's goals that you have? This is really the key, I think. Some of the goals that you have, there's like little dings and dents in. And I think that's why you might not realize that although you want your goals to be accomplished and you want that certain job or you want that house or, you know, you want to lose weight, whatever the case is, you want to quit smoking, you want that relationship. It seems like there's room for analyzing your goals, that there might actually be a part of your goals that are not as suitable for you as you think. Let me give you an example. All last year, I was working really hard on getting myself citizenship for Croatia. And, you know, a goal in the future when my children are older would be to live in Croatia. But I could not do that because, at least right away, because you can't homeschool in Croatia. Right now, it's illegal. And I'm a homeschooler. And I'm not going to change that. So Croatia going to have to wait, okay? It's not going to wait in its fullness. As it turns out, I didn't have to base my wishes off of that fully. I could start a process where I visit Croatia 6 months out of the year and then come back here and then go to Costa Rica and then travel a little bit more. And in that way, it was that traveling around that was actually more beneficial for me on a spiritual level than just deciding, all right, I'm settling down, I'm getting the house. I could actually make my dreams even bigger so long as I'm not afraid and I find the benefit and the gratitude of changing my goals a little bit, which I totally have. And boy, do I tell you, the manifestation is coming in very quickly on that one. Now, again, I feel like this point in the third quarter of the month after the 15th or so is that time where you get to really analyze what your goals are. See if they're actually worth like continuing on the way that you are or changing the goals up a little bit. It doesn't have to be a total change either. Because, you know, the Four of Cups does mean that there is still something that you can be grateful for with what you're establishing. But Diogenes holds a lamp in his hand, and that is a lamp that is called the lamp of truth. And so this gentleman here goes on a journey to find the truth. And see that little serpent? That little snake right there, that means that Diogenes has to make sure that he doesn't trip over things that might get in his way, like his own self, his own thoughts, his own overthinking, his own gluttony, his own, you know, negative habits. Oh, my baby. What's going on with my baby? And so you might very well find that much like this reasoning card of the Eight of Cups, there might be something that you either had to walk away from, and maybe that's why you're feeling the loss, or you do realize you need to walk away from it. It could even be that you're dealing with somebody who did a process of walking away, and now for some of you, it could be that you're on your own, and that's because it's the Hermit card. The Hermit is about being on your own. It's about having to do the hard work yourself. Some people have a harder time with that. Some people have been alone for a long time and, you know, it seems like they're professionals at it, but at some level, you know, they're frustrated with it and they have to go through kind of dealing with that. How to bring themselves up on their own or how to be alone and be okay with it and thrive even and survive even better. Now, the final quarter of the month here is going to be after the 21st of the month onwards to the end of the month of January. And we've got the King of Wands. So there's two things here. One, for some of you, you may be dealing with a King of Wands who comes into your life. But bear in mind, he is in the reversal, and the King of Wands tends to not be a grounded individual. So if somebody does come into your life, because we've got the partnership card here, the Four of Wands is sticking around. Just remember, the Four of Wands may be awesome. It may be about stability and unity, but it does have the satyr, and he's a lusty little bugger. It can be someone who might be a little bit too in their head, a little bit over-passionate, and perhaps their love life kind of gets in the way of accomplishing other things. Have you ever just, you know, and it's wonderful sometimes to be in a relationship where all you guys are is like about each other, but then, you know, you don't work on your work enough, your house enough, your other goals kind of go to the side. Be careful of that kind of energy. If it's not that you bump into somebody, again, instead of things like relationships, it could be that you are holding the energy of the king in the reversal. And the king in the reversal, again, he's got this ability to be ungrounded a little bit. And a need for you to still work on things like being grateful, being present, being, you know, accepting of how things are changing for you. And most importantly, the one key card in all of this is be okay with the slow progress. He likes to get things done because he's a king. When things don't go his way, he gets frustrated. So this is, again, a month for you to kind of work on that internal side of yourself that gets frustrated when you can't have things go your way necessarily as quickly as you want. We've all been there. You know, when I know it sounds terrible because it sounds like a childlike thing. Oh, they can't get what they want. But honestly, we as humans, as adults, do that a lot more than we realize. If a bill comes in the mail, we get frustrated if we can't figure it out the way we want. You know, even the mundane things. And so since this is at the end of the month of January, we want to see that as you move into February, that you are, you know, changing that, putting yourself at a more grounded level. And if you're dealing with someone who's not very grounded or is a little disorganized, even could be a boss, again, a parent figure, somebody who could be in like a higher position than you, like an authority figure, even someone older, like an uncle or something. Or a friend, even if they're the ones who are not being as organized as they could be, you're going to have to leave that on them. You do the best that you can do and don't let their energy tip your scales of balance and leave you frustrated. Again, these cards here have a lot to do with that portion of lifting yourself up and being capable on your own. And my apologies for my baby. I think it's like every five minutes or so. That's not a cry, just so you know. I'm a mother who loves all of her children, but that is the whining. That's the whining noise that he makes. That's the, you know, Hunter, why do you have my toy kind of whine? And I'm not going to interfere with them. They're going to have to deal with that on their own. they're socializing with each other, but apparently baby Joshua is not having it right now. So, yes, again, let this person... Oh, like I just said about my children, let them do it on their own. They're going to have to learn, and this person will too, whether that's your mother, whether that's your boss. And then as you progress later on into the month of February, you'll have more of an opportunity to see how that's going to develop. So with that being said, I'm going to leave that off for you guys until I do a reading for you for the month of February. And when I get your yearly horoscope uploaded, which I am going to be working on in these next couple of days, it will be uploaded for you fairly soon, a full review of what Libras are going to be dealing with in the year 2023 for every single month. So with that being said, I'm going to head off to do the sign of Scorpio. Thank you very much, and I will talk to you guys soon. Ciao for now.
Click and subscribe to have so much fun with card reading.
Hehehehe